Hello boys and girls, and welcome to another video on my channel. Over the course of years, I've been using many different phone mounts. Some of them were real junk, others pretty good. But today, in this video, I want to talk about quad lock motorcycle mount. I would say one of the most popular phone mounting solutions currently available on the market. And I want to focus specifically on the quad lock downside. Let me say this in advance, to clear all doubts. Everything said from now on in this video doesn't mean quad lock is a bad motorcycle mount. It simply means quad lock has downsides, like everything. And it's up to you to decide, can you live with those downsides or they will be a deal breaker for you. With that out of the way, let's go! Usual phone mount purchasing journey goes like this. When you finally convince yourself that dedicated sat-navs are thing from the past, and shortly after you figure out your phone can do actually much more than just show the map, like for example notify you about speed cameras as well. That's the point where you start looking at different options, how to mount your mobile phone on the bike. Now logical next step we all do is, of course, to ask Google what is the best motorcycle phone mount, and from this point on, quad lock will follow you everywhere you go, until you finally decide it's the best choice out there. And it seems to be a very good option. It's small, sturdy, mounts everywhere, and there's a plenty of customization add-ons to make it work for you. But nothing proves the quality more than its price tag, right? Even generally, quad lock is a good product. Like with everything, there are some downsides in using it. Downsides you won't find out for until you start using it yourself. But before jumping on that, let me just say mount I have on my bike permanently is quad lock mirror mount along with USB socket wired on my bike's electrical circuit. Please note, not on the battery directly, because that would drain it in a record time, but in the plug Honda created specifically for connecting third-party accessories. With that, let me show you a few real-life examples or downsides using quad lock motorcycle phone mount. First and most obvious one, quad lock requires a phone-specific case. And this might not seem as a problem at first.
I'll mention one more thing. So you see, I have quad lock here, and this is the downside of the quad lock. I have my phone mount somewhere on the other location, and of course on my phone, on this phone, I don't have a, you know, adapter to mount on a quad lock. So this is definitely, you know, a big downside of quad lock, which makes it unusable for me now.
But as you can see here, in real life happens that I don't have the case on my phone when I need it. In fact, my quad lock case is around 700 kilometers away from me, which makes my quad lock mount totally unusable at the moment, as you can see here. Also, quad lock case is too bulky for me to keep it on the phone all times. Another thing with the phone case is, what if I decide to buy a new, maybe not very popular mobile phone, for example Plus One, or any other phone that quad lock is not supporting. For example, I had the previously Samsung Note 8, quad lock never had a case for that phone. For me, this is a downside compared to, for example, RAM X grip mount, where I don't need to think about the case. I just pop the phone in and off you go. Second downside of quad lock is, in my setup, it often shows map upside down.
Guys, I just turned the camera on to show you one thing. One downside of the quad lock motorcycle mount, you can see, you know, my, I'm not sure, I'll look closer, but hopefully you can see my map is upside down, so practically, you know, I have no idea where I need to turn.
As you can see, this can be really annoying if it happens all the time. You can say this is an easy fix, just position your mount more upright, but I have a problem here. I can't position it more upright because it hits my windscreen and I cannot connect my phone with the mount that way easily, which makes it difficult to take it on or off the mount. On another hand, if I tilt the quad lock down slightly, I can't see the map properly. So even this looks like a perfect place for a phone mount, in practice things are different. And I can of course buy additional spacer from quad lock and then position the phone better. That would help, but I think I already paid too much for my quad lock mount. Third, my quad lock is pretty much permanently mounted on the bike. Many of us sometimes want a taste of adventure, so we fly to the location, rent a motorcycle there, and enjoy a moto adventure for a few days.
Thank you guys, have a good day.
Ciao guys, thank you.
My quad lock can't go with me to help me navigate around, because it's permanently fixed on my bike. This limits my set of uses for quad lock. Fourth, the final price of all you need is just too high for a phone mount. Now, this one is relative, and you might not agree with me on this one, but here's how I see it. My mount cost me around 100 euros, or 120 American dollars. And I personally think this is the price we pay for a quad lock branding, not for the quality of the product itself. For less money, I could have some quality and more versatile mount that I can carry around with me on my moto trips. Fifth, will this mount kill my expensive phone's camera? Let's be clear on one thing. Quad lock won't kill the camera. Bike's vibration might. But for a few extra bucks, quad lock has a rubber damper to prevent this. Add that onto your wish list. All this makes quad lock a rocket science system, and I'm a simple guy. I like simplicity. I just want a simple phone mount so I can navigate around on my bike. And finally, let me say I could mention more things, like waterproof case, waterproof USB socket when phone is plugged in, and other things. Generally speaking, quad lock might be the perfect solution for you and your needs, but I just wanted to point out some of its main downsides that I found the most irritating while using it. Now the question is, can you live with them or not? Thanks guys for watching. If you have any questions, comment section is below. I hope you enjoyed this different point of view on quad lock. If so, please consider subscribing to my channel and I'll see you all in the next one. Stay safe and take care.